ESPN's presentation of the Stanley Cup playoffs is brought to you by the cold-filtered light with the smooth draft taste. MGD Light, say no more. And by Visa, honored at over 6 million more places than American Express. Visa, it's everywhere you want to be.
With you on the island, where the Islanders, trailing in the series 2-0, will go to the third period with a 1-0 lead on the Canadiens.
And the hit parade continued in the second period, but the Islanders really picked it up. Montreal wasn't able to match them. The Canadiens are supposed to be a team that takes the body all the time, but Darius Kasparaitis started it with a big hit on Paul DiPietro. And as if one-on-one isn't bad enough, when the Islanders had their opportunities, they double-teamed and double-crunched Lyle Odelein. Kevin Haller. And the only goal of the second period is the only goal of this hockey game. It was scored by Pierre Turgeon and a terrific feed from Brad Delgarno. He found just enough room between Patrice Brisebois' skates right to the tape of Pierre Turgeon and right under Patrick Waugh. Waugh was surprised. He didn't even know it was coming.
And our Miller genuine draft scoring summary, the only one. Turgeon sixth at 136. Delgarno and Bollock picking up the assists on it. And now, New York Islander fans, they've been on their feet cheering here as the team came up, because the opportunity for them to get one W on the board in this series, and the man who has made the difference thus far is Pierre Turgeon. One note here, these New York Islanders lost a league-high 8 games in the third period during the regular season. They had a lead going to the third in those games and lost 8 of them. Nobody lost more than that during the regular season. Well, we'll see what happens here in the playoffs. Bellows drops it off. They have gone 3-1 in the playoffs when they've had a lead going into the third, and we're going to get penalties early on. 25 seconds into the period, Carey Fraser, Kasparaitis get into a shoving match, and there'll be matching minors coming up here.
I think Bellows is the Canadian that's going to go.
Earlier tonight, a very special moment here at the island. Dennis Byrd, the injured New York Jet football player, is a very good friend of the Islanders. These teams use the same training facilities. He was introduced. With a football injury, they thought he would never walk again. He already is up, standing, doing some walking, and all season long since the injury, they have worn his number, the Islanders have, on their hockey helmet.
He looks like he's doing great, doesn't he?
Doesn't he? What an inspiration. And a very much recognized individual now in the greater New York area. Malakoff plays it back in his own end. We're just underway here. Now we'll skate 4-on-4 in this third period. Malakoff leading it 1-0. Baskey near side in, takes the shot, deflected over Waugh's head as Desjardins got the stick on it. Another stoppage of play, and the faceoff will be inside the line.
No, that's a fan jumped up to grab that shot and took it right in the hand. Now he knows what it feels like for a defenseman to try to block a shot with the palm of his hand. Dennis Baskey really ripped that one. Out of University of Minnesota Duluth, Dennis Baskey said that his childhood hero growing up was actually Tom Kervers, because Kervers is about 7-8 years older, and Kervers won the Hobie Baker, the hockey equivalent of the Heisman Trophy, when he went to Minnesota Duluth.
Deflected to Malakoff. Malakoff shot wide of Waugh. Hogue tried to knock it down. Baskey saved Waugh. He felt that one. Patrick Waugh is up and skating. He's all right, but boy, that one caused the shoulder to dip down a little bit as it got him in the midsection. Baskey on the touch-up on the icing call.
Baskey has been a terrific player and an underrated player in the playoffs for the New York Islanders. He had a chance to play last season when the Islanders had so many injuries on defense, and he picked up where he left off last year this season. Two big rips by Baskey. Islanders continue when they get time to try to shoot it high on Patrick Waugh. Turgeon scored right under him, but all of the Islanders say there's lots of room upstairs on Patrick Waugh. It's just getting enough time with the coverage of the Canadians lay on you in the deep in the offensive zone to get the shot away.
Pierre Turgeon will take the faceoff. Daniel cutting out of the circle as Kirk Muller will move in to take the draw. Muller talking with Daniel here as he gets lined up. Gets the stick down, and Turgeon won it, but it ends up coming out of the zone. We're still 4-on-4 for another minute 22 here. Malakoff back in his own end with Baskin. There's Malakoff. Malakoff and Muller moving in. Great pass into the middle. 2-on-1 break. David Bolling to Turgeon. Oh, my gosh. He missed it, and he had Patrick Waugh way over on the side of the net. Malakoff blocked out deep. That one had a hurt. Malakoff, Muller still down on the ice after blocking the shot. Baskin, Muller down again. Waugh makes the save. And Muller will try and skate it off.
Kirk Muller, in spite of the fact that he was absolutely hobbled by the first shot from Malakoff, went down in front of Dennis Baskin to try and block the second shot. That tell you something about him? Malakoff with his cannon ripped it right into Kirk Muller. Looked like it might have hit him around the knee. He is shaken up. He gets to his feet, and with the Islanders still pressing, was able to hobble in front of Dennis Baskin. He missed the block, but he tried.
Still feeling it as Kirk Muller goes to the bench.
How could you not like the way Kirk Muller plays? Every team should have a Kirk Muller, should be lucky enough to have a Kirk Muller, including the New Jersey Devils.
Who once had him and let him go. And have missed the bounce of that kind of player. Faceoff will come to the right of Patrick Waugh. Islanders leading it here by a score of 1-0. 54 seconds remaining in the 4-on-4 situation. Islanders are trying to, for the fifth time in their history, come back from a 2-0 series and win it. They have done it four times before. One of those times was against the Montreal Canadiens team. Canadiens down a goal here, being shut out by Healy and company. Sent in by Keane offside as Proof blocked it. The faceoff comes back to center. No flow here for the first couple of minutes of the third period.
Here's a low angle look at Kirk Muller's block on Malakoff. Oh, man, worse than the knee, the ankle. No sweat, right, Kirk? Captain Kirk will be back.
That's my next shift. Off the faceoff, DiPietro won that one against Benoit Hogue. Canadiens chasing it down while Odelein comes back in his own end. Along the way, the Canadiens started up ice, didn't do much with that one. Good play by Hogue, shot. Good save by Juan. He looked behind him. Uwe Koop had the chance. Keane taken out of the play by Benoit Hogue. Great stand-up check and a penalty coming up. And I think it's going to be on the retaliation here. Gary Fraser making the call. Wait and see.
I don't know. Hogue looks like he's prepared to head to the box as well. High sticking against Benoit Hogue. And the Islanders just coming off three great scoring chances, Gary. You wonder how long they can hang on. There's the hit by Hogue. And then the second shot. But Carey Fraser obviously didn't see the retaliation by Mike Keane, or that'd be an even call.
Could be a very important penalty called in this game. The Montreal Canadiens get the power play, trailing here by a score of 1-0, unable to convert. They've had two chances in the game, one in the first, one in the second. The Islanders have gone 0-for-4 on the power play. Jacques Demers is instructing behind the bench. Muller right back out on the ice. Now this is a huge power play opportunity now for the Canadiens. It will be a 4-on-3 situation since we already had matching minors. The minors still have 16 seconds remaining on them.
It's almost as if the Canadiens are going to have to hope for a power play opportunity because the Islanders have just closed them right down at even strength. They only have 11 shots on goal and we're 2.5 minutes into the third period.
Big faceoff win. Tom Fitzgerald in this game taking the big faceoffs and beating Kirk Muller. Breeze block. Dumped it ahead to Muller. Power play Canadiens. Muller. Aerial pass. Desjardins the shot. Missed it. Healy had come up and cut the angle down. Now a 5-on-4 power play for the Canadiens. Full minute 37 left on it. Ryan Bello starts it up ice. Bello with Dampus and Muller working up front. Brisebois. Desjardins back along the point. Held in by Brisebois. Far side. Bello. Muller. Bellows again. Bellows going back to the point. Desjardins, near side, just held in. Brisebois shot blocked deep. Krupp tries to clear. Can't. Held in by Brisebois to Bellows. Bellows. Danfus on the far side. Shot taken Desjardins. Blocked again by Brian Mullen and out of the zone. Desjardins goes back to get it. 58 seconds left on the Canadiens' power play. Brisebois to Danfus. Danfus got it in. Vasky blocked it to Mullen. And Mullen will just wait. Mullen sends it into the zone at Delgarno cutting. Forces Patrick Roy to come out to get it up for Brisebois. 40 left on the power play. Brisebois. Delgarno just stepped up from behind and took it away. Outstanding move by Brad Delgarno. Canadiens trying to regroup here. Making a line change, so they took it back. Bellows still out on the power play. DiPietro and Gilbert Dion are now up. Dion in the corner, avoiding at least partially that hit put on by Pilon. Dion behind the net. Pilon still with him. Pilon takes him out again. Canadiens still on the power play. Centered for Bellows, who gets driven into the net by Brad Delgarno. And Gary Fraser's going to let that one go. And now at center ice, Pilon gets hit in the face with a stick of Kevin Haller. All the way back at the blue line, Pilon and Haller, and Haller got him in the face. Gary Fraser was down by the net. And I think there's nothing in all of this.
There was a lot going on. Gary Fraser was trying to spread out. Listen to this. You know, but when you're down a man, you go for those big hits. Sometimes the guy will spin away the way Dion did, and there were two Canadians headed to the net. But Richie Pilon has had a harder time in this series lining up the big hits than he did against the Pittsburgh Penguins. The Penguins have good size up front, but very often that good size is easier to line up than the small, quick Montreal forward.
Our Visa storyline, the only goal, six of the playoffs, Pierre Turgeon for the Islanders. 10-game win streak on the line for Montreal, and the last Islander shutout in the playoffs, Billy Smith. 5-10 of 83 against the Edmonton Oilers, 2-0. 16:01 left to go here in this third period. The power play has 10 seconds left on it for Montreal. DiPietro has moved in for the faceoff, a tough one because it's back along the line here. Try and hold this in. It's won by Fitzgerald again. What a night he's having in the draws. Krupp's got it. Islanders need one more clear. That wasn't it. Went over the glass and into the seats.
Well, Gary, we have talked about Steve Thomas. We mentioned him in the second period. He's not getting much ice time. He is right at the end of the bench, which is usually the spot that's reserved for people that aren't going to play. And I don't know if Steve Thomas is hurt. Well, looked like he was getting ready to come out. He hasn't been out on this period yet. I don't know if it's doghouse or injury, but you'd hardly think with his work ethic and his hitting ability and scoring ability that Al would sit him. I imagine we'll read about it tomorrow, but right now I'm baffled.
Certainly looks all right. When he's been out there, he's skating okay, but just don't know why. Back to the point. Desjardins shot. Healy! Big club save!
How do you order a Miller Genuine Draft Lite? The cold filtered light with smooth draft taste at a singles bar.
Give me an MGD Lite.
Anyone have change for 20?
We'll let him in here.
Say MGD Lite and say no more.
When light turns up the heat.
Can they start the wedding without me?
This shouldn't take long, honey.
Nothing protects you like Degree Antiperspirant. It's body heat activated to release extra protection. Degree, your body heat
it.
Turns it on.
I hate it.
Just northwest of Kalispell, Montana, there's a place where you can punch cattle instead of a time clock and discover what horsepower is really about. It's the Hargrave Cattle and Guest Ranch, where you can ride them and rope them like they used to. But if you go, you got to pull your own weight and pull out your Visa card. Because at Hargrave, they don't take the tin horns and they don't take American Express. Visa, it's everywhere you want to be.
We'll be back here on Saturday night for game four, regardless of what happens in this one. And right now, it's the Islanders leading 1-0. In front of the net, Vasky came back to get it.
Well, we know now that Steve Thomas is not an injured player because he is out there. He just hasn't played very much.
There's Thomas right there with the puck. Thomas getting around Mike Keane. Nice drop pass from McGinnis. Back for Thomas. Thomas McGinnis. Turgeon trying to bat it out of the air after Wise knocked it away. DiPietro to Danfus. DiPietro, Keane, and Danfus. Danfus in for DiPietro. Kept it wide. Malakoff there with him. There's Thomas. Thomas starting it up. Thomas rinked wide that time to McGinnis. McGinnis into the zone with Thomas. McGinnis. Thomas the shot. Reflects to the near side corner. No one's got her yet. Kasparaitis sends it in. Glove down by Patrick Wilde. He hangs on, but the Islanders are keeping the play in their offensive zone, leading here 1-0.
Brand new line combination in this game for Al Arbor. He'll do that. Thomas out there on one side, on the right side, with Marty McGinnis on the left side. Pierre Turgeon at center. Thomas came out like a guy that was healthy and had been sitting on a bench.
It's one of those we're just going to ask Al Arbor after the game.
Yep. He ripped that shot at Patrick Waugh, sensing that Turgeon was in position for a rebound. See where he goes. Well, he climbed back on the bench and sat right down on the end as if he expected to stay there.
Ray Ferraro comes out on the ice. He's got Flatley and King with him. The draw pushed out of the zone. Jesse Ballanger has not played a lot tonight. Winning that faceoff back into the Islander end. Ferraro can't handle that. At center, J.J. Daniel. Daniel working defense here with Lyle Odolin. Dion shot. Save made by Healy. Push to the point. King bats it out of the zone. Lyle Odolin again there to get it and send it in. As the Canadiens do the dump and chase here, but the Islanders are getting there first. Rube Coop worked it from behind his own net. Ferraro back to Coop. Had that one blocked by Dion. Dion almost able to intercept that in the slot. Shot on Wah. Save. Where's the puck? King taking the shot. Going for the five hole that time. And Patrick Wah makes the save.
Almost looked like the six hole. Right at the Canadiens logo, but nobody's ever scored through the six hole. A little high for the five hole by Derek King, but man, the Islanders are pressing for that breathing room. You hardly want to nurse a one-goal lead heading into the last part of the third period. That shot was right at Patrick Waugh.
Quick changes being made here as the Islanders keeping the legs on the ice they want here. Canadiens not getting many chances in this game. Look at the shots on goal. Single digits, all periods, both teams. Pretty amazing. That's the way this game has been played. Very tough. DiPietro and Turgeon. DiPietro wins the faceoff. Delgarno puts the hit on. Delgarno trying to center as he tried to kick it out in front. Penalty coming up. And it's going to be on the Canadiens. Matthew Snyder holding on to Delgarno as he tried to go after the puck, and the Islanders get another power play.
Stick call. We haven't seen that many in the playoffs, but that is the signal that Terry Fraser gave. And, you know, it's a good call because if Delgarno didn't have his stick held, he looked like he was going to dance right out in front. So when a real score, good scoring chance appears to be denied, to me, it's a must call. Watch it right here. Delgarno with the squash on Matt Schneider, and then Schneider holding his stick. And you see, if Delgarno's loose, he just dances around in front and tries to wrap around.
That's the sense an official must have for the game. It makes a really good official. If it doesn't affect anything, you probably let that go. If it's at the other end of the ice, and it doesn't matter. But that affected an offensive chance and a good one. You realize that immediately, and Terry Fraser makes the call. There you see the Ophirs tonight as far as power plays are concerned. Right here, Islanders with the advantage. Kerbers to Malakoff. Malakoff trying to get it in front for Delgarno. And a block comes to Kerbers. Tips it down low. They'll have Bollock setting up in front of the net. Shot on Wah. Save made as Turgeon took it. Delgarno back for Turgeon. Rene moves over to get it. Rene gets it by Malakoff the length of the ice. 13:50 to go. Third period. Canadiens lead in the series 2-0. Islanders returning home here with a 1-0 lead on Turgeon's goal, an even strength goal in the second period. That has been it scoring-wise. Pucks against the boards. Bollock dug it out, lost it to Carbonneau. Brunet over to get it. And while Brunet can't get it by Malakoff, who held it into Delgarno, who got dumped. Almost hit Malakoff in the head, cleared out. Then Healy at the other end. Both 15. Change it up the fly. Kervers comes back to get it. Bobby Kervers starts it up. Turgeon stays out on the power play. And Thomas comes out with King. On the far side, King held it in for a moment. Not enough. J.J. Daniel drives it in on Healy at the other end. Coop comes back to get it. Mike Keane back there on him. Again, the Islanders getting new legs out on the ice in this power play. Uwe Coop near side, Ray Ferraro. Ferraro the move. Ferraro while on line in front of him. King's got the puck. King. Baskey back at the point. Baskey and Coop. Baskey shot. Waugh, the save as Ferraro tipped it down and in on Patrick Waugh. Kurt Muller clears. 28 seconds remaining on the power play. The Islanders leading 1-0, but not able to convert here on the power play chances. Ferraro with Thomas. Thomas in the far side. Ferraro cutting, tried to get it to him. Blocked. Desjardins, and he cleared it out of the zone. Baskey back to get it. 13 on the power play. You see the clock running on it. Kervers onside. Kervers tried to center Thomas. It went between Thomas and King. Guy Carboneau brings it out of the zone, and the penalty's over right now. Matthew Snyder out on the ice. Carboneau's all alone. Kasparaitis takes him off the puck on the stand-up check. So they do not convert. Neither team able to do anything with the power play. Remains 1-0 Islanders. Thomas starting up on the far side for the Isles. Dropped it back. Kasparaitis in the middle. King. Not quite as he reached for it. Daniel gets it over to Brisebois. Brisebois in the middle. Islanders and Montreal both changing. It's an offside call here on the Canadiens if they touch this puck up. Right there they do, and that'll draw the whistle. 11:45 left in the third.
Only one movie has the greatest war hero. The most evil dictator. The most devout religious leaders.
I haven't seen a woman in decades.
The most incredibly exotic women.
If this is about me coloring my hair.
And all five living ex-presidents. It can only be Hot Shots Part 2. Rated PG-13. Starts tomorrow at theaters everywhere.
How do you order Miller Genuine Draft Light? The cold-filtered light with smooth draft taste? At a fern bar? You don't. MGD Light is far too cool for a fern bar. Say MGD Light and say no more.
The best defense is not to offend. Thus, introducing the new Right Guard Sports Stick. Now with a time-release formula for longer-lasting protection against hostile odor all day. For protection that endures.
Gary Thorne, Bill Clement. They've got it on at the bar where everybody knows your name. They're watching this game. Deep, stay right here. We need enough to go there. Loisel clears it out the center. Islanders leading 1-0. Good try. Well, you can say that because you know the bosses are all watching it too. J.J. Daniels got it. 11:30 left to go. Cleared into the zone. This has really turned into a defensive struggle. Touched up by Baskey. That will draw the whistle on the icing call. 16,297 on hand here at the Island tonight.
Well, we talked about Al Arbour really holding Steve Thomas back. I haven't noticed John LeClair forever.
Nope.
From the Montreal bench.
Been lots of stars sitting around watching this game for reasons we don't know.
Well, you know, Montreal never has established their hitting game in this hockey game, and John LeClair usually leads them in that department, but the Canadians tried to keep pace with the Islanders hitting in the first period, but they haven't.
Guy who's seen a lot of ice time is DiPietro, who moves in to take the space off. He's been out there a lot tonight. One of the reasons is he's done a good job on the draws. Claude Loisel is out there against him. Loisel wasn't sure if he was going to play tonight. Al Arbour was waiting to see whether or not Montreal put more muscle in this game. Guys like Todd Ewan or somebody like that, they did not. So Loisel got the play, and Mick Dakota got scratched. Face off, one back by Dantzler that time. On the near side, Brunet out of the zone. DiPietro puts it by Baskey into the corner. Brunet going after it. Baskey there. He and Brunet collide. DiPietro pokes it away to Dantzler. Dantzler still has it. Loisel has him. And that, of course, is the puck to center. Good play by Claude Loisel. Wow, Odeline has to take it back in his own end. There's 11 minutes left to go. Third period, far from over in this one. 1-0 Islanders. Shots are 23-13 in favor of the New York Islanders. Brunet didn't get it in. Baskey pinned him up. Loisel has sent it up in the air. Odeline blocked it. Baskey's there. Dumps it in. Matthew Snyder back to get it. Both teams, again, legs on the ice here. Schneider, a blue liner. Deflected with a swoop and a stick on it. It ends up in the seats. Not a lot of room right now to do much of anything out there.
You know, coming into this hockey game, you had to think the one thing working against the New York Islanders is for the first time in this year's playoffs, the Islanders in game two lost a game they could have and probably should have won. Underdogs get into situations like the Final Four by winning games that they should have lost. I mean, let's face it, game seven against the Penguins, they were outplayed, outshot, chance. The one thing that doesn't fit into the equation is goaltending, and Glenn Healy was superhuman. But the Islanders in game two against the Montreal Canadiens for the first time in this year's playoff lost a game they could have, probably should have won. That will work against them in this series.
Kasparaitis brings it in for the Islanders. Kasparaitis sends it in. Wow. Puts it in the glove. He had Thomas moving in on it, so he hung onto it. He has not hesitated to join the offensive play in this playoff season.
Canadians do such a good job with their mobility of forcing the play wide. Eric Desjardins here forcing Darius Kasparaitis just to flip a harmless shot, and you can see there's pretty good coverage there on Steve Thomas too as he's trying to get there for the rebound. Everything from sharp angles. And when did Glenn Healy make his last tough save?
Too long ago to remember. Where's Randy when we need him? Yes, that's right. Shot, Kasparaitis. That deflected as Mike Keane went down to block it. Played by McGinnis. McGinnis up for Thomas. Muller poke checked it away. And Lahoe couldn't hang on. Islanders have not given up breaks to the Canadiens. They are back in covering. Shot by DiPietro. Hit his own man, Mike Keane.
That was Gilbert Dion's shot, but still.
And after the whistle.
Yeah, I mean, Dion knew it was offside, so he was trying to be kind of smart by ripping it at Glenn Healy. And it backfired by getting Mike Keane. And there's no question Dion knew it was offside. I mean, it was offside by a mile.
Big kid, you gotta do that. Make sure I'm not there. 10:09 remaining to go. Third period. 1-0 Islanders on top. Turgeon's goal, 1:36 of the second. Delgarno and Volek in the even strength goals. Canadiens in their history here during the regular season. Games played here in New York have won 19, lost 16, tied 4. They won both games played here this past year against the Islanders, lost one at home. Kurt Muller, the spin. Dropped off behind the net. Keane trying to get a screen from Dion to Muller, knocked away Kasparaitis. Then Lahoe coming to get a chance for a 3-on-2 break here. Holt moving in, drops it, McGinnis offside. Dennis Byrd, we showed you earlier, the New York Jet football player who was injured, paralyzed here tonight, standing ovation, worked with Jeff Norton and the Islanders.
I had the good fortune meeting Jeff Norton during workouts over at the Jets complex while he was working out to get in shape for his hockey season. Of course, I was working out to get in shape for the football season. And we just sort of began a dialogue a few years ago, and it's just kind of been a running thing, and I'm very fortunate to be able to call him a friend.
And I'm sure Jeff Norton feels the exact same way. He's on hand watching the game here tonight from one of the boxes.
Well, the fans are trying to rev it up, but the Islanders just cost themselves a real good scoring chance going offside in a 3-on-2. It was Thomas and McGinnis and then Lahoe, and I'm still not sure who went offside.
Turgeon going to the bench to get a new stick, delaying the faceoff here.
Remember, that was a problem in game one. Al Arbor said we must have gone offside 50 times. Well, the Islanders have been much sharper since game one. But still, you've got to make sure at this stage of a hockey game, we're down to 9-something to go with a one-goal lead. You can't go offside.
Montreal Canadiens have lost only 2 games. They are 10-2 in the playoffs this season. The Islanders are 8-7. But in this series, the Islanders can get the win. It'll be back to a 2-1 Montreal lead. And it's Healy out to get it. Look at it. That is by Lehman. Turgeon played at the center to Bollock. There's a 3-on-2 break the other way. Bollock brings it in. Canadiens get back. Delgarno behind the net. Tried to bounce it over the net that time. He wanted to get that out in front by going over the top with it. Brisebois the other way. Brisebois to Bellows. Bellows. There's LeClaire. LeClaire tried to line it up. Curvers lined him up and took him down. Gary Lehman in the corner. Jesse Balaguer rather in the corner. Ajay working in front while Odeline was cutting in. The defense for the Canadiens joining the play now with 8:57 to go here. Shot, Bellows save, rebound, kick to the corner. Healy, the big save. Uwe Krupp looking at goaltender as Healy's been knocked down. He waited for him to get back in net before he did anything with the puck since nobody was on him. 1-0 Islanders. Wild little line to the red line. The flip in. Malakoff back to get it. Pietro took a charge at him, but he got it out of the zone. Icing call coming up here. And touched up by Matthew Schneider. And we're down to 8:26 left here in the third. Still none. 1-0 on that man's goal, Pierre Drouin.
Now, Sports Illustrated brings you all the thrills of the Cowboys Super Season. In this sensational new video, Cowboys Super Bowl Champions. It's free with your paid subscription to Sports Illustrated. The best way to get inside the action for over 24 million readers.
How about them, Cowboys? Yeah!
The boys are back, so call this toll-free number now and let Sports Illustrated make sure you're with them every step of the way on their run to glory. Call now and you'll also get the special commemorative issue free with your paid subscription. It captures the Cowboys in championship style. And get 54 issues of Sports Illustrated for only $1.39 an issue. Save over 52% off the cover price. For quicker delivery, use your credit card. Your two free gifts give you the thrills of the past year.
Dallas, your Cowboys are the champions.
Sports Illustrated gives you the great moments yet to come. Nobody's into sports like Sports Illustrated. Get into it.
It gets real tight for both these teams right here.
What a great cheerleader. Jacques Demers is pumping his guys up and trying to cheer them on. And meanwhile, Glenn Healy's getting a little equipment repair from Carey Fraser. Because if Healy goes to the bench for an equipment repair, Mark Fitzpatrick has to come in. A little suspender snapping maybe at the back of Healy's pants. Here's the traffic that was in front of him. He got crushed by John LeClair. Look at his right leg bent back. I was worried when I saw it about his right leg, but everything was okay ligament-wise. Just suspender-wise was busted.
8 minutes and 26 seconds left in this third period. The Canadiens now sending at least one defenseman in here to try and create offense. It's Brisebois doing it right there. Brisebois got by Ferraro to force the play in. They're going to take chances here, try and get this game tied up. Cleared out by Fitzgerald. Desjardins back to get it. Lehman. Lehman has not played a lot tonight. Falling down along the boards that time. Flatley's got it. Centering for King. Taking out Desjardins. Pass comes out of the zone for Ferraro. Ferraro avoids the hit of Mike Keane. Poked the head. No help there. And Lehman will just send it into the zone. Barry Lehman playing in his fifth playoff game this season. A goal and an assist in those games. Ferraro brings it in. Ray Ferraro, centering pass. Waugh has to knock it away. Flatley got tied up. Keane with Muller racing in a two-on-two. Muller brings it to the... No, Muller comes to the middle. Keane tried to get it to him and couldn't. Robert Dion lost it. Wild over line and Ferraro. They've been tied up here at the other end. Well, off the puck is taken all the way down to the other zone. Muller brings it back in. Kurt Muller drops it off. Schneider's shot. That was wide. Dion was setting the screen. Lyle Odeline holds it in. Again, Dion. Dion has Flatley on him. Dion, Keane. Keane shot. Held on to by Healy with Muller there.
Well, the Islanders over the last couple of shifts have been a little late in getting their man-to-man coverage shaped up in their own end. And that is a tendency that you'll see with teams trying to protect a one-goal lead. You don't want to make a mistake, so you hang off him just a second. We saw that at the end of game two, the Islanders doing just that. Here, Claude Loisel did a good job of getting out to Lyle Odeline and try to force him out of the blue line. When you come to the guy at the point, you got to keep moving on him. Follow through on the hit to force him out of the blue line. You don't know what's going on behind you. The puck might be coming right back to you, so you got to drive right through the guy at the blue line.
Glenn Healy had the only shutout picked up by the Islanders during the regular season this year. His teams didn't do a lot of that. Even the Canadiens had only three. Cleared around the boards for Mullen. Mullen can't get it by Desjardins, who held it in. Now out of the zone, Mullen's got it. Mullen with Fitzgerald and Loisel. In the corner, Kevin Haller. Fitzgerald on it. Haller has the puck. Can't get it by Krucci. Shot wide. Rebound. Mullen. One dumped it deep. Haller goes over to get it. 6:40 left to go third. Loisel and LeClair collided. Loisel and LeClair still battling to the middle of Bellows. Bellows. Belanger coming. Belanger's in a little room over there with Bellows. Bellows for Belanger. Deflected. Good defensive coverage in front. Tommy Corbett's up for Mullen. Mullen breaking in. Mullen on Wah. Saved by Wah. Leaves it for Haller. Haller has Mullen move right in on him. Both teams change it. Bellows again sends it in. Then he'll head to the bench. Malikoff back to get it. Malikoff up and out of the zone. J.J. Daniel. Daniel. Bounced off Bellows. At center. Bellows has got it. Bellows drops it. Waiting to clear. They do. Shot saved by Healy on the point shot by DiPietro. DiPietro surprised Healy a little on that one. Sent in by Bollock. Knocked down by J.J. Daniel. Daniel for Brunet. Rolls by him to DiPietro. Poke checked away there by Vasquez to Turgeon. Turgeon, his own blue line, just sends it in. Shots 25-16. Islanders the advantage there and leading 1-0. Canadiens trying to force the play. Build a rush here. Drop to center. Asparitis to Bollock. Elon right back in. Islanders are just going to get it at center and get it into the zone. Brunet. And they make a quick change. The Islanders do. Dampus in. Dampus with Kasparaitis. Kasparaitis ties him up. Puck left behind the net. Delon can't clear it up. Dampus diving center. DiPietro save. Rebound. Save. DiPietro turn up. Shot. Score! The Canadiens have come back on the rebound to tie this game up with 5:14 to go in the third period.
Well, Glenn Healy stopped a couple of terrific chances, and finally he needed help, and it didn't come. Healy was flat on his back, or at least sitting on his rear end. After this shot by DiPietro, you can see that he loses his balance. Benoit Brunet took another swap at it. Three Islanders took Brunet. Nobody took Vincent Dompfus. A backhander up and over. Glenn Healy has tied this with 5:14 to go. The coverage was great for the Islanders. Look, everything was fine until Steve Thomas skated behind the net and tried to jam it between Kasparaitis and Dompfus. It hit a leg and came back, and that created the problem for the New York Islanders. Their coverage was perfect up until Steve Thomas tried to dump it out.
Dompfus now 1-1 in this series. You saw that is his ninth of the playoffs this year, and they have tied the game up at 1-1. So after all that work by the Islanders, they've got to go at it again here with 5:08 left to go in the third period. They get the goal on their 18th shot of the game.
Benoit Brunet picked up an assist. Here's the DiPietro chance, followed by the Brunet swipe. And then the Islanders really scrambling for coverage. It never did shape up the way they wanted it. Watch Healy. He couldn't even get his right hand up. It looked like it was stuck under him.
There are the fans again, trying to make some noise. Wah knocks it down. 14-46, Dompfus. From DiPietro and Brunet. 16th career playoff goal for Vincent Dompfus in the first of this series. Lyle Odelin sends it in. Odelin back at the red line again. Right back in on Healy. Left behind the net for Uwe Krupp. 4:42 left to go. These teams played a double overtime in the last game. King the shot. Wow, the save. Rebound poked away by Muller, who was diving on the ice. Mike Keane. Keane bringing it in. He's all alone with Krupp. Canadiens changing. Leon had joined the play. J.J. Daniel skips over his stick to center. And an offside on the Canadiens. 4:20 left, but we're now tied at 1.
You guys are going to love this hole. Let's see what you got today.
It is.
A little left to right.
Whoa! Ugly shot. Yeah,
don't look at it.
Trust me, that is where you want to be.
Come on, let me show you where it's at.
Oh, yeah.
The party has started.
You are beautiful. Gentlemen, what'll it be?
Miller Lite.
4. Get it? 4.
For great taste and a less filling beer, join the club.
So what's the rest of this course look like?
I have no idea.
Miller Lite. It's everything you want a beer to be.
To demonstrate how Subway's dropping the price of our 6-inch cold-cut combo, I'm going to bungee cord drop off this bridge. The 700-foot vertical drop gives me ample time to remind you Subway has the freshest-tasting sandwiches anywhere because we bake our own bread, cut our own vegetables, and make sandwiches fresh before your eyes. And now with this price drop, our cold-cut combo's just $1.49.
Thanks.
You're welcome.
The 6-inch cold-cut combo, $1.49 at Subway, the place where fresh is the taste.
Little equipment repair for Patrick Waugh. He just came up with a nice save on Derek King. The Islanders with all of the good scoring chances. This shot is top of the circle, but it's pretty decent angle, so Patrick Roy just went down into his butterfly style and made a save. And look at his focus. He's looking right down at his pad where the puck made contact. He's been a focused goaltender. He's made some terrific stops. He's only allowed one to get by him.
He is one of only 40 goaltenders ever to have 200 lifetime wins in the National Hockey League. Four joined that group this season. Wah was one of them. Mike Vernon, Kelly Rudy, and John Van Beesbrouck, the others, who crossed the 200 win mark for goaltenders. Sent in by Desjardins. Islander fans, obviously, stunned, sitting back a little bit right now to see what happens in this. Islanders have got to regroup, but not that way. That's an icing call. Desjardins on the touch-up, and Canadians will take all those face-offs in the offensive zone they can get right here.
Yeah, you bet they will. You know, the Islanders, too, in this series, I really noticed that when they get the puck in deep around their net or behind the goal line, most of their defensemen don't even bother taking a look up the middle. They just ram it high around the glass or around the boards. And so they're going to take a lot of icings. The Montreal defense, even though they are young, two 22-year-olds, a couple of 23-year-olds, they usually take a peek up the middle. And very often, Montreal, while the boards are sealed off, can get it out the middle. The Islanders use the boards more than Montreal.
I mentioned about winning a game in the third period. National Hockey League, the total number of games played during the regular season, only 9% of the time does a team that goes into the third period trailing win a game. It's very unusual for that to happen in the National Hockey League. You mentioned the Islanders. Breeze-wise shot blocked. The Islanders eight times in the regular season lost a game in the third. That was high in the National Hockey League. Toronto Maple Leafs and the Los Angeles Kings tomorrow night. That season moves out to La La Land. 10:30 Eastern, 7:30 Pacific. That's 1-1. Then, Saturday, Montreal Canadiens and the Islanders go at it again here on the island. We'll have it for you, 7:30 Eastern and 4:30 Pacific. All the way through the Stanley Cup Finals. You'll see every game right here on ESPN. Faceoff in the corner. LeClair pinned up by Vasky, dropped it off behind him. Turgeon poked it away but couldn't control it. Canadiens putting the heat on. That one went through and Bellows shot, and Healy had to knock it away, and he was screened. They wave off any icing here. 3:38 left to go. Third period, game tied at one. Islanders have taken the lead at 1:36 of the second period on Turgeon's goal. And here in the third, Canadiens coming back late. Get it tied up. Danforth putting it in. Pilon gets it out the center. Delgado to Turgeon. Turgeon tied up nicely by Lehman. And Ballanger played Brisebois. Off Delgado's back. Pilon. Trying to reverse. Couldn't. Heard it around the dasher. David Pollock tried to touch that one. Did enough to slow it down while Odeline's got it. Odeline to Brune. Brune had it back up. Odeline there. Odeline. John Bruce stays off with Brune. Goes off the back of the net. DiPietro out there. He moved in. Turgeon swinging around the board. Flatly trying to get it out. Knocked down Kasparaitis. There is Kasparaitis. Trying to send it in. Desjardins was there. Canadiens passing the puck well here in the third. Brune to DiPietro through the screen. It deflected off a skate wide. Ray Ferraro's got it. Ferraro three on three the other way, and that one is blocked.
Second time the Islanders have come to the blue line and tried to make a play, and here comes Montreal. Those pucks have to go in deep.
Danforth near side to Brune. Brune, the shot. That's blocked by Uwe Krupp over the glass into the seats. 2:25 remaining in regulation.
J.J. Daniel just limped off. He came on for about a 10-second shift. It looked like he was in a lot of pain, so he left very quickly.
Bill is a man we never talk about. The backup goaltender for the Montreal Canadiens, Andre Risiko.
Well, we don't talk about him that much because he doesn't get a chance to play very often, does he?
He watches a lot of hockey. But he has a great seat.
Especially in the playoffs.
You're back up to Patrick Roy. That's the way it is.
The LA Kings are the only team of the Final Four that haven't gone exclusively with one goaltender since the playoffs began. Andre Rasico played a few minutes in the Quebec series just because Patrick was shaken up, but Patrick was able to get back in and preserve the win.
Roy played in 62 of the regular season games. Resico appeared in 26 of them. Game tied 1-1. 2:20 to go in the third period. Brisebois on his own end. Tipped into the zone by Muller. Healy back to get it. Leon and Keane along with Muller on this line. Muller pinned it up on the boards. Keane to Muller. Muller. Very dangerous when you get to this point of the game. He, like Turgeon, one of those guys who wants it.
Ooh,
Oh, he gets decked from behind. No call as Thomas moved in and one unhappy. Kurt Muller on the far side. Thomas brings it up ice. Thomas with Benoit Hogue in the middle. Backhand shot. Did not get in on goal. Matthew Schneider was there to knock it away. Keane coming. Keane drops it. Chris crossing in the middle. Schneider shot. Blocked deep. Both teams rushing. Kasparaitis, nice speed to get it out of the zone. McGinnis. McGinnis. Thomas and Hogue. McGinnis. And then McGinnis pinned up by Muller from behind. Thomas behind the net. Benoit Hogue. Schneider was there. Not out. Pilon. Turnaround shot deflected wide. In the corner, Schneider again. Schneider pushing at it. Hogue got it. Thomas moves in to help out. Benoit Hogue still has it. Players down in front of the net. Burton Muller is out there. They're just laying on each other. Pilon the shot. Just wide of Patrick Roy. No call. There's Muller and McGinnis are just getting up off the ice. Schneider and Hogue. Schneider will turtle on this one. Wants a whistle. He's not going to get it. Now he does. And lucky there's no penalty called on him for delay of game on that one.
Couple of huge hits from behind, too, on this last shift. Thomas buried Mike Keane in his end. And then Lyle Odlein came in and did the same thing to Steve Thomas. But while all the play was going on, I kind of thought the Islanders would pick up on this and just try to drift one in front. They had the screen set up and a lot of traffic. McGinnis looks like he's trying to get up, and Muller just looks like he's wrestling with him, keeping him down. He got the pin. I counted to three.
Ten.
The lying ten count. Here's the shot behind the net. Watch Odlein. Boom on Thomas. On Hogue, rather, and then came up high on Thomas. Matt Schneider was the guy on his knees. He just wanted to get the whistle, and he got it.
He had run out of legs. Krupp back to get it. Blocked. John LeClair. LeClair. Krupp on him and tugging down. No penalty. Move A. Krupp. Good play in the middle. Breezeball. The shot. Deflected wide. LeClair tipped it. LeClair still in front of the net. Can't get it to him. LeClair, the turnaround. No shot. Cleared out of the zone by Kerbers. Turgeon brings it. 35 left to go in regulation. Turgeon, Wah blocked it to the side. Going for the game winner, Pierre Turgeon. Time remaining in regulation, 25 seconds. Bollock and Brisebois, game tied at one. LeClair, someone to feed to, can't get it up. Now Dodds, 2-on-1 break. Bellows on the right, Guy Carboneau. Bellows shot, missed it. Carboneau back for Bellows. Bellows looking, waiting in front for someone to set up. Can't get it there, blocked. Bollock, 6 seconds left to go in regulation. Melikov and run on the legs. Turgeon, one final shot. Wow, the save. We're going to overtime.
Well, neither of these teams looked like they wanted any overtime, did they? In the last couple of minutes, terrific chances. Brian Bellows had the game on his stick, but he tried to redirect on the pass from Carboneau and just shoved it about a foot and a half wide. Watch it. He never did stop it. He just tried to one-touch it, and it was too far in front of him to even try it, so he missed by 2 feet. Pierre Turgeon, just before that, cut in. Very often, these kinds of shots will just jump up, and you'll be able to get it with your equipment and bounce it in the net somehow. It got caught up in everybody and went by.
We are going to overtime again. The Canadiens and Islanders tied at 1-1 at the end of regulation. John?
Gary and Bill, once again, no spots. 1-1. We're headed overtime for the 23rd time this Stanley Cup season. That is a National Hockey League record. And boy, was that an interesting last 2 minutes of the game. And what it essentially, you have to say, it was a pretty dull game to that point.
Yeah, it really was. The first period was pretty good. And then the checking got very close, very tight, the last 2 minutes, end to end. So you have to wonder, is this the way overtime's going to begin? Get this thing over in a hurry? Boy, I hope so.
Essentially, as you said, it's overtime as soon as the Islanders were tied in that game with the Montreal Canadiens. We will have an overtime ahead. We're tied at one apiece. Game two went to double overtime. What's ahead tonight?
Suffer from trouble as varied as nature itself. So turn to the source of advice and good ideas, Ortho. It's our nature to help.
Your car doesn't just get you from here to there. It's a part of your life. To give your car complete protection, Texaco has developed Havoline Formula 3 Motor Oil. With not one, but three kinds of protection against heat stress, starting friction, and engine dirt. Havoline Formula 3. Add more life to your car.
Or your travel agent. Your best bet is a Best Western.
What's my day like? The sun comes up and my calls start coming. You want help calling overseas? I'm right here. Your kid needs to call you collect from camp. You need someone who speaks your language? I can help. Now, if you want to trade casserole recipes, my husband is the cook. By sundown, I've helped some people out. And if I'm lucky, there's a casserole waiting on the table.
The iPlan with a smile. AT&T operators.
The Stanley Cup Playoffs. The magic of the 93 Stanley Cup Playoffs is yours forever with this power-packed video. You'll cheer the overtime victories, last-second dramas, and hockey's star-studded performances. You'll find all the spectacular players and plays in the official 93 Stanley Cup video. To order for $19.95 plus $4 shipping, use your credit card and call 1-800-688-1993. That's 1-800-688-1993.